our president will start a war with Iran because he has absolutely no ability to negotiate. He's weak and he's ineffective. So the only way he figures that he's going to get reelected, and as sure as you're sitting there, is to start a war with Iran. Now, I'm more militant and more militaristic than the president. I believe in strength. But to start a war in order to get elected, and I believe that's going to happen, would be an outrage. Iran can be taken down in many ways. Their population is in turmoil. They look at what's happening in Syria and other countries where it looked like it was an impossibility, and it looks like that one's going to collapse also. So Iran can be taken. I would never take the military card off the table. And it's possible that it'll have to be used because Iran cannot have nuclear weapons. But you've got to exhaust other possibilities. And we're in a great position to do it. They know, or they at least must know, that they're in a little bit of heat because there's a lot of pressure to attack. This is a great time to negotiate. Unfortunately, we have a president that doesn't know the first thing about negotiation. We have a real problem in the White House. So I believe that he will attack Iran sometime prior to the election because he thinks that's the only way he can get elected. Isn't it pathetic? Well, they finally cleared out the protesters, and it's about time. It's great that the protesters are no longer allowed to put up their tents and have a lot of fun or whatever they were having. I don't mind protesting, but you know what? You have to have a point of view. You go down there, and they're basically protesting everything. They don't even know what they're protesting. Some of them are real people that have real and legitimate complaints. Others are down there for dating purposes, for having a good time, and maybe it's working. And then some are down there for bad reasons, for evil reasons. And they started getting more and more of them. So it's great that it got broken up. It'll probably come back in smaller forms, but they've got to know what they're protesting first. You have some very good people there, but you also have some real lemons. So, congratulations. It's sort of over for now. Let's see what happens in the future. But tents and living like that, it should not.